In a quiet corner of North Norfolk, a very unusual flock of birds has been creating quite the buzz. Now, if I told you about a bird that was cherry red, ultramarine, green, and bright yellow, you'd probably think I was making it up. And you certainly wouldn't expect to see it here in a quarry near Cromer. Have you guessed it yet? It's the bee eater. Oh, and there's one right there in the hole. With the help of the landowner and the local bird club, we've been able to safely protect this colony and allow people some really unprecedented views. A really nice community has formed around these birds. People have been coming to see them, but people have also been able to see them via a live nest cam installed by the RSPB.
They first appeared around the Jubilee weekend, I think. And as I remember it, it was pouring with rain. And now look at it, it's basking sunshine, and here we are in this fantastic quarry for the first time ever for breeding bee eaters in Norfolk.
What's been great, actually, as well as seeing the birds, is the reaction from the public. We've had all sorts of people coming from all over the place, from holidaymakers to the keen birders, and the kids as well. You know, you never forget your first bee eater, so hopefully seeing that will have created a really good, positive wildlife experience that they'll never forget.
So the bee eaters live in North Africa and Southern Europe. They eat butterflies, bees, and dragonflies. They dig with their little feet in the dirt and then they go inside it and lay eggs.
I've seen them in Cyprus, and I've got an apartment in Turkey, and you could hear them, but you can't see them, they're so high up. I'm all the way to Turkey and come back here for a close-up. Yeah, it's amazing, absolutely amazing.
So while it is fantastic to see bee eaters in the UK, it is a very vivid reminder that climate change is here and it's happening. This is a species that's being pushed further north as the planet warms, and there's been a flurry of increased nesting activity in the UK over the last 20 years from bee eaters. Hotter, drier summers are going to become the norm unless urgent action is taken to curb greenhouse gas emissions. But for now, there seems to be plenty for the birds to eat, from butterflies and dragonflies to bees, and it's not expected that this small colony will impact on the local ecosystem. As the daylight fades and night sets in, the work of our team on the ground takes a different approach as they set up for the night to protect the nest from intruders and predators.
At the beginning of June, 4 bee eaters turned up in North Norfolk, where we are in Trimley. They were spotted by a local bird watcher, and he saw them starting to excavate down here in this quarry. The RSPB were notified, and we immediately set up a presence. We are now down here 24/7 to protect these birds from predators and people.
You've got the day shifts where you'll be doing sort of 12-hour stints of helping people get on the birds, engage with the public as well, but also still keeping that monitoring as well. The night shifts that will then consist of another 12-hour stint of making sure there's no egg collectors.
As the project nears the end and the chicks are almost ready to fledge, the risk of predation is a lot higher. So the chicks are obviously making a lot of noise before they fledge. Prime target for a badger or fox or stoat. The other night, it's quite a few badgers actually. We had 3 badgers and 2 foxes. So I think we've got to be really on the lookout tonight. You hear them coming back through the undergrowth.
Well, I suppose when you've also got red-legged partridge and pheasants roosting on the ground, it's almost sort of like a safe barrier.
Yeah, a natural tripwire.
Pretty much.
Yeah. Look up on these banks.
There's a badger at the top. You've got that top shelf. Just want the light on it, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
He doesn't look it doesn't really look interested in the nest. It's just sort of just doing its own little thing.
Yeah, just snuffling away.
Bee eaters are full of surprises, and no one can predict when or where they're going to turn up next. We've had them in Cumbria, the Isle of Wight, and now Norfolk. But what is for certain is that the RSPB will always be ready to spring into action and protect these really quite special birds.